we head into the Thanksgiving holiday, it must be noted there are a lot of Virginians struggling financially because of the devastating impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic. Some are still waiting to find out if they even qualify for unemployment benefits.
Others are on the verge of losing their small business. Problem solver Melissa Hippolyte has been helping one woman for months in her fight to receive benefits and save her business that helps kids with special needs.
Oh, very excited, very happy, love everything.
Occupational therapist Sally Walker Cruden opened her own business, an outpatient clinic in Midlothian for kids with special needs, in January.
Primarily, it's right now it's pediatrics, children with developmental delay, autism, ADHD, cystic fibrosis, Down syndrome.
Within 2 months, she had to shut Cara Therapy down.
When pandemic hit on March 13th, I had to close my doors all the way until we didn't really reopen until September.
In those nearly 6 months, Sally says she lost all of her income. She applied for unemployment through the Virginia Employment Commission in April, and they abruptly stopped her payments in June. Sally ended up being one of tens of thousands in Virginia who had some sort of issue with their claim that needed to be adjudicated by a hearing officer.
Called, I went online, nothing happened until I reached out to you, and then a process started.
She finally contacted CBS 6 after waiting more than 4 months, and within days, we were able to help her get a hearing, which led to her getting paid benefits.
I paid for my mortgage for my townhouse, and then I paid for the clinic.
The money gave Sally a huge boost, and yet she knows others are still struggling. According to VEC spokeswoman Joyce Fogg, there remains a backlog of around 70,000 claims with issues, and the agency is just getting around to adjudicating claims filed in July. Despite getting her VEC benefits, Sally is now facing a second pandemic hardship.
It just seems like just when there's a small little light at the end of the tunnel, boom, something else hits me.
Earlier this month, the landlord for her business told her that she owed 2 months' worth of rent and that she would be evicted within 14 days if she didn't come up with roughly $8,000.
And I'm in sheer panic. I mean, I'm not sleeping at night.
Sally showed us her business bank account and pointed out two large payments in October that appear to be for September and October rent. But a representative for the landlord told us he never received them.
I reached out to the bank. They said, well, you'd have to come in and fill out a form, and it takes 10 to 14 business days to investigate where the money went.
But after the problem solvers contacted the landlord's representative, they agreed to give Sally until December 4th to pay September through December rent.
I love what I do. I worked very hard for that clinic, and I just would like a little bit more time. It's not that I don't want to pay him.
A representative for Sally's landlord told me they had no record that they'd ever received those checks for September and October. Sally told me she's initiated an investigation with her bank into what happened to those checks. Working for you, I'm Melissa Hippolyte for CBS 6.